Charlotte Mason's approach to mathematics is so brilliant and very unique, and a big part of it is something called mental math. What is that? What does it look like? That's what we want to focus on today in the podcast. Welcome to the Simply Charlotte Mason podcast. I'm Sonia Schaefer. Joining me today is Rochelle Babordina, and we are talking mental math today.
Yes.
Now, for those who, that's a new term possibly, or those who just need some clarification, what is mental math?
All right. So if you'll remember, we have a little rhyme, new review, and mental math too. These are the three components of Charlotte Mason math lessons. And mental math stands on its own, even though at this point, during arithmetic, our lessons are largely oral.
Yes.
And in any math lesson, our students are going to expend a lot of mental activity. So how does mental math stand on its own? Well, this is a 5-minute time set apart where all of the manipulatives or everyday concrete objects are put away, and we're going to engage the child in lively, rapid questions that are within their scope of learning.
Okay, you said rapid. How rapid?
All right, so rapid is definitely relative. The mental math time is going to increase a student's ability to rapidly answer questions, but that's going to progress as the child progresses in their learning.
So as in everything, we teach the child.
Yes.
And go at his pace.
Correct.
Maybe just gentle, mm-hmm. You know, lean on the elephant type thing.
Right. And you can watch your child, just like when giving a dictation lesson, you can add in your pauses. You can slow down, and you give the child the time they need to think and answer the question.
Good. Okay. So why are we doing this? What's the purpose? Right. And I can see the benefits. As mm-hmm. you said, they're gaining some mental speed where they can calculate quicker mm-hmm. over time at their own pace.
Yes.
But what else? What's the purpose of this? I'm sure, because Charlotte Mason usually has like 25 purposes
right.
for everything she does.
Right, because these are methods that lay on top of principles
yes.
in the math lesson
yes.
and in any lesson. But we remember that Charlotte Mason favored the living math lesson for its ability to nurture good habits in our children. So that's one of the top reasons for mental math. So there are mental habits such as attentiveness.
Attention. Yes,
right.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the big three, right?
Yes.
In habits,
right.
We want careful execution.
Yes.
Some abstract thinking is going on here.
Oh yes, because they don't have the concrete manipulatives
right.
anymore.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's a good stepping stone between that concrete lesson going toward abstract thinking.
Mm.
And then she said that mental habits are going to lead the child into moral habits, which we might not think about in correlation to a math lesson, but independent, honest work,
yes.
and accuracy
yes.
are two of these moral habits.
Yes, that makes total sense. And even in a math lesson, I mean, it for the teacher, that can elevate this 15 or 20 minute time, mental math, 5 minute time,
yes.
it elevates it in your head that it's not just, oh, here we go again, let's
mm-hmm.
do it. But there's a real purpose
yes.
to it.
Yes, Charlotte said that these habits are going to stay with the child throughout his or her life.
Mm-hmm. All right, so you said it's part of the lesson.
Yes.
Talk a little more about those specifics, like
okay.
where are we doing this?
Okay.
Does it have to be at the beginning of the lesson, at the end of the lesson,
mm-hmm.
another time? Does it always have to be at the same time as the lesson?
Right.
Do we have to be sitting in our little chairs? You know, talk about the details here.
Okay,
let's get the nitty gritty.
Right. All right. So this can be given any time during the lesson when you see that your child's attention is waning or maybe she seems to be getting tired. And so we have that, you know, a change is as good as a break
right.
or a rest sometimes.
Right.
So we can switch to the 5 minutes of mental math and kind of freshen the child up.
So it'd be like, okay, let's just set that aside for a few minutes
yes.
and we're going to do this now.
Mm-hmm.
and just kind of give them that little boost
yes.
of energy. Because it's mm-hmm. the rapid, that makes your adrenaline go
yes.
when you have that rapid.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good.
Yes, so it is a change. Or it can be given at the end of your math lesson as kind of this grand finale.
Really kind I love
of,
that.
Yeah, a fun way to end the math lesson
yeah.
is with mental math. Now, if you've already lost your child before the time of the math lesson is up, then you can just save it for another time, or you can give more mental math at any time throughout the day. It can be during a walk, it can be around the dinner table, it can be, you know, if you're running errands, if you're in the car. So this 5 minutes of mental math can be given at different points.
And I remember you talking about at some point your kids were doing mental math with each other, or they were suggesting
yes.
it wasn't mm-hmm. all teacher initiated.
Right. So as teachers, you know, we can have our book that has the mental math included, but it's a great idea to have your child make up his or her own questions and pose them to you. If you have multiple students, then they can pose questions to one another.
Mm-hmm. Which is what my grandkids do.
Yes.
You've seen the little video mm-hmm. with, I think she was six at the time, 6 and 4 at that time. And they're running around the kitchen island, and one of them dashes into the pantry, and the one running around the island gives the mental math problem, and the one in the pantry opens the door and pops out and gives the answer. It's like, it's just part of their play.
Right. It's so wonderful.
Yeah, it was fun. All right, so a lot of people are going to be saying, yes, but what does it look like?
All right.
So now these are always questions within the student's scope. So these are review.
Yes.
Things that they have already mm-hmm. mastered and the concepts of,
yes.
and they're just working on the memorization, I mm-hmm. guess you would say, of recalling those facts quickly,
yes.
right?
Yes. It is within the student's scope, and so you could be actually doing a much more complex work in your new section of the math lesson,
mm-hmm.
but your mental math should be within their ability as you slowly climb with them up that hill or that mountain. We could be using smaller numbers rather than larger numbers. So they could be, your student could be doing long multiplication, but their mental math might not include long multiplication.
Okay, so clarify for me, because we've got our big three, new, review, and mental math too. Mental math is a type of review, but
yes.
what I'm hearing, and clarify this if I'm wrong, okay? What I'm hearing is we have our new concept, like if we're working on long division.
Yes.
But the review is going to be closer to that new concept. It'll be like just one step behind.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, we were doing this and that leads to this. Where the mental math can be anything back to the first book.
Yes.
Okay.
But, you know, we don't want our child to be bored during the time of mental math, but it can be any time. So definitely reviewing multiplication tables, reviewing addition and subtraction in a little bit more lively way than if they were doing, say, some written work.
Yeah, and it's not just drill, you know,
correct.
where I give, you know, 6 times 7,
mm-hmm.
9 times 4. It is much more engaging than that, which is where we want the demonstration to come in,
yes.
if I have the guts to do this.
So,
which book are you pulling these
so
from?
So I have pulled mainly from book 3, because I want to give you all an idea of what a student, perhaps third grade student, will be working with in mental math and just what their abilities are at this point.
Okay, I think I can do third grade.
All right,
we'll see. Or at least the third book. All right. And do you usually start a timer when you're doing it, or do you just keep an eye on the clock?
Mm-hmm.
How does that work?
So if we're outside or in the car, believe me, this can go on for much longer than 5 minutes.
Do you let it?
Yes, as long as the children are engaged, we'll just keep going for it. I remember there's a Parents Review article where a parent had talked about how her husband said no more mental math around the dinner table because the children weren't actually eating their food. They were just having fun
just
with mental math.
That is so
yes.
fun.
But during the lesson, we'll set a timer for 5 minutes.
Okay.
And I think it will surprise you at how long 5 minutes of mental math actually is.
Okay.
So I'll set my timer.
We're ready. Can I peek at the... No, I won't peek. I won't peek.
All right. We've got our timer.
And this might give our listeners a good opportunity to see what you do when somebody gets a mental math problem wrong.
Right.
We'll see how this works. Yes.
Martin has 4 apple trees, 2 peach trees, and 3 pear trees. How many fruit trees has he?
He has 9 trees.
Cosette picked 7 pink roses and 7 yellow roses. How many roses has she?
14.
Nick and his brother each checked 6 books out from the library. How many books were checked out in all?
12 books. Now, let me ask this real quick. Mm-hmm. You can pause if you want to. Am I supposed to be giving the whole equation?
At this point, you can just give the answer. It's usually in the earlier years with the addition and subtraction when they're first learning what that even means that we want them to give the full answer. It will help them retain their facts.
Okay. Thank you.
Lucy is 8 years old and her brother is 2 years older. How old is Lucy's brother?
10.
After paying 5 cents for a gumball, Abram has 20 cents left. How many cents had he at first?
Oh, that's a good one. 25 cents.
Good. 9 is how many more than 4?
5.
6 added to what number makes 10?
4.
8 added to what number makes 13?
5.
10 is how many more than 2?
8.
Lydia rode her bike 12 miles in April and double that amount in May. How many miles did she ride in May?
24 miles.
If you bike 8 miles in an hour, how many miles can you bike in 3 hours?
24.
How many gumballs at 5 cents each can we purchase for 30 cents?
6.
How many 4s in 12?
3.
How many inches make a foot?
12.
If you divide a foot in half, how long will each half be?
6 inches.
What does 1 foot take away 5 inches?
7 inches.
Good. How many inches added to 3 inches make a foot?
9. These are
what
good.
Are you? If you subtract 4 inches from a foot, how many inches remain?
8.
How many half inches are there in 1 inch?
2.
How many half inches in 3 inches?
6.
How many inches in a foot and a half?
Ooh, 18.
If you had 12 inches of ribbon and you cut it into 3 equal parts, how long will each part be?
4 inches.
How many 2-inch pieces can you cut from 1 foot of ribbon?
6.
Carl caught 7 fish a day for 4 days. How many fish did he catch in all?
28.
2 pepper plants each contain 8 peppers. How many peppers altogether?
16.
I see we can move on to something a little more.
Oh,
difficult.
Don't assume. Keep it within the student's scope here.
An artist had 19 paintings and sold 7 of them. How many had she left?
8. No. 19 minus 7 is 12. 12.
Rachel had $20. She gave $5 to her brother and spent $4. How much had she left?
$11.
Liam has 23 miniature figures. He's painted 12 of them. How many has he left to paint?
11.
Now we can move to some abstract or pure number.
Okay.
What is 3 taken from 5?
2.
3 taken from 12?
9.
3 taken from 77?
74.
3 taken from 34?
31.
From 29?
26.
From 48?
45.
From 91?
88.
If there are 8 crayons in a box, how many crayons in 5 boxes?
40.
How many legs have 3 kittens?
12.
How many legs have 7 kittens?
28.
How many legs have 10 kittens?
40.
How many legs have 8 kittens?
32.
How many ears have 6 dogs?
12.
2 boys.
4.
How many ears have 3 dogs and 4 children?
Oh, goodness. This is nice. 14.
How many ears have 5 girls and 4 boys?
18. Two-parters. Yes. These are so good.
What is 5 taken 6 times?
30.
5 taken 8 times?
40.
What is 7 taken 6 times?
42, and that's my... Yay, saved by the bell!
Good job.
So I love how those were just multiplication, division, yes, addition, subtraction, but they really were engaging, and especially those two-parters. Mm-hmm. I assume you wouldn't do the two-parters for the younger grades, but up into third grade.
In third grade, you're
getting there.
They will be there, and yeah, we didn't even get to fractions. You'll be doing mental fraction work in third grade as well.
Yeah, well, we did a little of it when we were taking, yes, half inches and half of, yes, this, but it was just that gentle introduction that Charlotte's, mm-hmm, so good, yes, at.
And it really kept you on your toes.
It did. It did. About... I'd say maybe about the 4-minute mark, mm-hmm, my brain was kind of like, oh, this is getting hard. It's okay. It's okay. We're almost, yes, done. Hang in there. And it so I'm not saying it energized me, mm-hmm, but it did keep me on my toes.
Good.
It helped with perseverance, yes, and focus, trying to pay full, mm-hmm, attention. I will say if we had done this, now we're doing this in the morning.
Yes.
If we had done this after supper tonight, mm-hmm, it would have taken me twice as long to answer each question, right, I think.
Right, it probably wouldn't have been that fun.
Yeah, yeah. So this is great. This is great. Thank you for this demonstration. It's not something that I grew up doing in my education. Mm-hmm. We had timed worksheet drills. Right? You know, to review, mm-hmm, our facts. And it was just pure number on those, yes, worksheets. But this is so much more engaging.
Yes.
I can see, too, how it's building a relationship here.
Yes, it's building a child's relationship with the parent as well as a relationship with numbers.
Instead of, here's your worksheet, setting the, mm-hmm, timer, walking, yes, away. There's no relationships, mm-hmm, going on there.
Yes.
So this is fun.
Yes.
This is good.
And you can also see just how much that builds these good habits. One,
yes,
of my favorite habits that Charlotte Mason mentions is steadfast thinking.
Mm.
And mental math is really good at building this steadfastness. Even with how you persevered, you stayed steadfast.
Yes, and holding those numbers in your, yes, brain. That, yeah, it all plays into it.
Yeah.
So many great habits,
mm-hmm,
in a lively, interesting, engaging way, building relationships, 5 minutes a day. You can do this all the, yes, way up through 12th grade, right?
Right. We can use a definite oral component, no matter which, you know, the complexity or the branch of mathematics the child is studying.
And where do people find these mental math equations, mental math, mm-hmm, ideas here, concepts?
So we have them throughout the Charlotte Mason Elementary Arithmetic series, but you can get good at just whichever textbook you're using. You can start to look at, oh, these could actually be given orally. All of these questions could be given orally. Some textbooks do have them built in, even in trigonometry or algebra. They'll have an oral component built in.
I love how in the Charlotte Mason Elementary Arithmetic series that you wrote, mm-hmm, you have notes in there like, if you don't get through all of these in the lesson, just, or if your student has already passed this and you're,
mm-hmm,
ready to move on, just bookmark this page and come,
mm-hmm,
back and use it for mental math.
Yes.
It's just, of course, yes, that makes total sense.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And if your children have already learned their math facts, then you can bookmark those questions from the table work and,
mm,
use those for mental math as well.
Yeah. And I've been doing where I'll use those questions, but I might change up, you know, rather than how many kittens' ears,
mm-hmm,
I would say how many kittens' feet or how many tails. Or,
yes,
so you can just tweak one word,
mm-hmm,
here or there or tweak the numbers,
yes,
and reuse them,
yes,
as needed.
When you twist and turn these questions, then it makes it even more fun. The child doesn't know what's coming.
Yes. Yeah, you don't want to reuse, mm-hmm, the same ones every time.
Right. Yes.
Great. Thanks so much for helping us with mental math. Next,
mm-hmm,
time I'm going to ask you the questions.
Okay.
Okay.